We have announced yesterday we are supposed to hear as our first resource speaker for today, PNP Director General De La Rosa. He is supposed to make a report or presentation. May we know where Director General De La Rosa is now? Is he in the premises already? Nandiyan na po ba siya? Si Director General De La Rosa ba ang talagang magbibigay ng presentation?
Yes, ma'am.
Is in the premises already?
Yes, ma'am. He is, ma'am.
2 minutes suspension.
Madam Chair, may I brief you on our war on drugs through a PowerPoint presentation for a clearer understanding of our campaign. This presentation comprises of the current situation, the PNP's previous initiatives composed of managing police operations and contra droga charlie, our current initiative, campaign plan on anti-illegal drugs, double barrel, which consists of the two approaches, Project Tokhang and Project HVT. The death under investigation or those reported killings which are outside of the police operations. The current crime situation is an improvement as indicated in the decrease of total crime volume in the first 7 months of this year as compared to the same period of last year. The situation on the illegal drugs affectation would show that based on PDA records, 11,321 barangays or 27% of the 42,036 nationwide are considered as drug affected. In Metro Manila, the drug affectation is grimmer with 1,611 or 94% of the 1,709 barangays being drug affected. While in Region 3, the number of barangays affected is 2,446 or 79% of its total barangays. And Region 4A has a 75% drug affectation. There is a total of 144,202 individuals on the BADAC-generated watch list on illegal drugs, with Region 3 having the most number followed by Region 4A and Region 13. The police has been employing different initiatives in the past to address the crime situation as well as the drug problem. The PNP had implemented the managing police operations, which focused the police efforts on the 7 prevalent crimes at the time, or what we call then as the 7 focus crimes. This police crime management included the deployment of more policemen to saturate high crime areas and high traffic convergence zones through the implementation of patrol operations to increase police presence. To address illegal drugs, Contra Droga Charlie was implemented to synchronize and strengthen the implementation of anti-illegal drug operations through the 5-point strategy: demand reduction, supply reduction, international cooperation, legal offensive, and community involvement. However, this campaign plan did not completely solve the problem on drugs, as the National Household Survey of DDB in 2015 would show that about 1.8 million are drug users and pushers, and has even reportedly escalated to 3.7 million. The president, recognizing the drug problem in the country, made the war on drugs as one of his priority programs. The PNP, therefore, in compliance with the directive of the president, introduced a more focused police operational concept against illegal drugs and crafted the anti-illegal drugs campaign plan, Double Barrel. The PNP campaign plan Double Barrel is being implemented to clear all drug-affected barangays across the country, conduct no-let-up operations against illegal drug personalities, and dismantle drug syndicates. It is being conducted on a two-pronged approach named Project Okhang, which is the conduct of house-to-house visitations to persuade suspected illegal drug personalities to stop their involvement in drugs, and Project HVT, or High Value Targets, which is a massive and reinvigorated conduct of illegal drugs operations targeting drug lords and drug syndicates. After 7 weeks of implementing the Double Barrel, we are pleased to report to the committee that we are getting a headway in this campaign. The police has now persuaded a total of 673,978 drug personalities to surrender and personally appear to the police stations for processing. Also, a total of 11,784 users and pushers were arrested, while 756 were killed during police operations. And contrary to the perception of some sectors of the society, the police operations in Double Barrel would show that the focus is really on Project Okhang, or in the conduct of house visitations in order to persuade users and pushers to stop with their illegal activity, as there are more surrenders and arrested than killed drug personalities as a result of the police operations. The pie chart clearly indicates the greater volume of surrenderers than the number of the arrested and killed drug personalities. The accomplishment of PRO3 would show a total of 50,523 surrenderers, 1,777 arrested, and 173 killed drug personalities. Meanwhile, PRO4A reported a total of 61,809 surrenderers, 952 arrested, and 77 killed drug personalities. The SRPO accomplishment in Double Barrel shows a total of 38,766 surrenderers, 2,927 arrested, and 230 killed drug personalities in their AOR. On the accomplishment of the PNP in the Project HBT, one high-value target named Mikutan, Jeffrey Diaz alias Jaguar, is the number one drug personality in Central Visayas. Franz Sabalones, the number two in Central Visayas. Mikutan was killed during the conduct of police operations. Well, 32 were arrested, 9 of whom are Chinese nationals. May I just show that there are now 9 police operatives and 3 soldiers killed and an overall 25 wounded. Next slide, please. May I just show that there are now 9 police operatives. Next slide. Yeah. And 3 soldiers killed and an overall 25 wounded while in the performance of anti-drug operations. This is just to illustrate that there is indeed a clear danger on the lives of our men in the operations against illegal drugs. As we review the index crime volume of July this year, we see that there is a decrease of 31% from last year, which is also an indication of the success of our anti-drug campaign, which started on July 1, 2016. The comparative statistics on the 7 focus crimes also show that there is a general decrease from last year. The blue graph shows July of 2015, while the red bars showed July 2016. A downward trend could also be seen on the weekly review from July 1 of the 7 focus crimes. This particular slide would show the crimes against persons such as murder, homicide, and physical injuries. Likewise, a downtrend is also seen in robbery, theft, carnapping of motor vehicle, and carnapping of motorcycle. It is in rape incidents that we could see a very significant decrease from where we started in July 1. The nationwide daily average of the focus crimes decreased by 49% from the average of 499 incidents for the second semester of 2015 as compared to the average of 256 during the same period this year. This daily average. The daily overall crime trend from July 1 to August 21, 2016 would also indicate a generally improving crime situation with a decreasing number of incidents from the highest peak of 353 on July 4 to 29 of August 2016. The crimes versus property and for crimes against person from 27 of 17 July to 23 on 21 August 2016. Everything goes down. Everything went down. The campaign plan, Double Barrel, is also giving a more focused direction on our internal cleansing as we rid our organization of personnel who are part of the drug problem. A total of 130 were positive in the random drug test of PNP personnel. Likewise, for those who were placed in the DI counterintelligence watch list, 6 have been administratively charged, 7 faced criminal charges, 11 were killed as a result of our police operation, and 20 were arrested. So if you have seen, Your Honor, even our own people are also victims in our police operations. They are also killed. The police is kalawags. The PNP also initiated the transfer of personnel who are believed to be involved in illegal drugs. A total of 284 personnel have been transferred to new assignments. The PNP likewise had issued the orders to police holding admin unit of 42 out of the 70 personnel who had been identified by the president to be involved in illegal drugs. The other 28 are either retired, AWOL, and for some reason could no longer be transferred. After a month of operating, we have developed different best practices in the implementation of Double Barrel. And these are some of the best practices initiated by a handful of our PROs, which I wanted the other unit commanders to replicate in their respective areas. We have been PRO 1, PRO 3, PRO 4A, PRO 7, PRO 8, and also in PRO 12, wherein the lot of Senator Pacquiao was loaned to the police for this purpose, for livelihood of those surrenderers. The PNP has operationalized the synchronized communications in the anti-illegal drugs campaign to strengthen interagency coordination and cooperation. May I now report to the committee those deaths that occurred outside of police operations or what we term as death under investigation. There are a total of 1,160 persons who were killed outside of a police operation. There, and this is the distribution by age bracket of the 1,160 DUIs. Most of those DUIs belong to the age bracket of 31 to 50. And the list number is below 18, colored red. We have only 18 incidents throughout the country. There are two PNP personnel, 8 AAP members, 29 elected government officials, 10 government employees, and 1,111 civilians whose deaths are still under investigation. The number of incidents in the DUI total to 1,070 and broken down to the following nature of the incidents. 939 shooting incidents, that's a colored orange. 69 stabbing or hacking, that's colored maroon. 19 strangulations or sinakal, and 48 others. On the motive of DUI, initial investigations revealed that 273 were because of the victim's involvement in illegal drug activities. 33 were done because of personal grudge and 7 were because of theft, while 757 are still undetermined as of the moment. So we would like to make it clear, Your Honor, that all this, not all these DUIs, death under investigation, are drug-related cases. Meron po na motive dyan ay as far as our investigation went on, we established that some of the motives are either grudge, theft, and other causes, other motives. But the 757 are still remain to be determined. A total of 212 cadavers were found, 80 of which are with karatula, and 23 were hogtied. Yung karatula po, stating or written on the karatula is, ako'y drug pusher, or huwag niyong tularan, ako'y drug pusher. Yun po yung sasabi natin with karatula, 80 of which. Out of the total number of DUI incidents, 309 were perpetrated by motor riding criminals. May I just report to the committee those dates which were investigated and therefore removed from the DUI files. There were 268 number of incidents which resulted to the death of 285 victims, meaning there are incidents which resulted to multiple victims, more than one victim. As to the case status, 100 cases were cleared and 168 solved. A case is cleared when the suspects are identified and the corresponding criminal case is filed in court, and a case is solved if the suspects have been arrested. From July 1 to August 22, there are 25 number of incidents done by motor riding criminals. The following are the other activities relative to the implementation of double barrel: the evaluation of unit commander's performance, the validation of reports, the conduct of an assessment on the social impact of double barrel through GIS and the operationalization of CENCOM. These are the challenges faced by your police in the war against drugs. Some local government executives and other officials are unsupportive and uncooperative with the PNP's anti-drug operations. The huge number of surrenderers expose the unpreparedness of the LGOs to process these drug personalities, especially in their rehabilitation, and to include its lack of corresponding budget. And we are not blaming the LGOs. The PNP's relentless campaign against illegal drugs continues to gain momentum, given the full support of the government and communities, as manifested by the number of surrenderers, the implementation of anti-illegal drugs campaign plan double barrel contributed to the significant decrease in the total crime volume, particularly on the 7 focus crimes. Likewise, the PNP continues to investigate murder cases categorized as death under investigation and found cadavers. The implementation of the PNP anti-illegal drugs campaign plan double barrel has established a more focused approach in eradicating the illegal drug menace. The campaign's significant gains in the following aspects cannot be discounted: the disclosure of true picture of the country's drug problem, the voluntary surrender of drug personalities to the authorities through the persuasive efforts of the PNP, and the no-let-up police operations and arrest of drug personalities resulted in the reduction of crime incidents. Likewise, the government's war on drugs is highly appreciated and supported by the general public. Just before I went up this hall, Your Honor, a number of barangay captains from NCR are outside expressing their support to the PNP. In closing, we reiterate that the PNP will sustain the momentum against crime and lawlessness in accordance with its mandate to serve and protect the Filipino people. I hope that what I presented is substantial to what we have discussed this morning. Thank you again and good morning to all of us.
Thank you, Director General De La Rosa, for that comprehensive presentation.